Hi, my name is Stacy. In this video, we'll talk about one of my least favorite things, taking notes. I mean, who can listen to the instructor, think about the information, and write it all down at the same time, especially when the student next to you is texting or even browsing the internet? Thank goodness there are strategies and tools that can make this job easier. This video will show you how the right technologies, along with an effective note-taking strategy, can help you capture all the important information in class. That is, as long as you go to class, of course. My favorite note-taking strategy is called the Cornell Method. Once you understand how it works, you can use it either on a laptop or with a pen and paper. To use this method, you need to divide your page into three sections, like this. The first column is used to identify the main idea or the keywords of a class. For example, if my intro to psychology class is about the nature versus nurture debate, I add the first term there. The main section here is where you record the core of your notes. This is where you write explanations, definitions, examples, and other important information. So as I listen to my psychology instructor, this is where I note important points. And what about the bottom section? You reserve this for after class, when you are rereading your notes. In this section, you summarize your notes and maybe even add a few points to take from your textbook. Think of this bottom section as proof that you've already started studying for your next test. Although I use the Cornell method, sometimes a little extra help would be nice. Recording devices are just the thing. Recording in class means that you have backup in case you can't write everything down. You may not want to listen to all the lectures a second time, but it could help you complete that right-hand column we just discussed. This is a recording pen. It looks like a regular pen and writes like one too, except it also has a digital audio recorder. But unlike regular digital recorders, this pen links the audio it captures with the words that I was writing at the same time. In other words, as I'm reviewing my notes and want to refresh my memory about a concept, I can select the word and hear what my professor was saying at the same time I wrote it.
In other words, as I'm reviewing my notes and want to refresh my memory about a concept, I can select the word and hear what my professor was saying at the same time I wrote it.
See what I mean? How cool is that? Of course, any audio recording device can be helpful, whether it's a conventional recorder or simply an app on your smartphone. You might also want to try one of the many free note-taking applications that are available. The trick to really making the most of these devices is keeping your recordings organized so you can find them easily. Some recording devices let you bookmark or tag sections for quick access. These are great tools to keep everything organized and in one place, and includes features like automatic date inserts and tags so you can easily find what you need. If you want to access your content from more than one device, then choose a tool that saves your information online so you can synchronize and access your notes from any computer or handheld device. Best of all, most of these note-taking applications allow you to include audio, photo, or video files. This can come in handy if you're using a handheld device that has a built-in camera. A quick click, and you can record everything on the board. Finally, don't forget that these tools are not limited to the classroom. You can use them to take organized notes for group projects, personal activities, or even in the workplace. Well, that's it for me. If you would like more help with note-taking or other learning strategies, contact your student service department, and don't forget to check out our other resources on our website. See you in the next video.